आई एम निसार अहमद एंड टुडे आई विल टॉक अबाउट चेक शॉर्ट सर्वे इट्स एप्लीकेशंस इन ऑयल एंड गैस इंडस्ट्री एंड कंपैरिजन बिटवीन चेक शॉर्ट एंड वीएसपी मेथड्स। हियर वी गो। चेक शॉर्ट सर्वे इज आल्सो नोन एज वेलोसिटी सर्वे। पीवे वेलोसिटी ऑफ द फॉर्मेशंस इनकाउंटर्ड इन अ वेलबोर कैन बी मेजर्ड डायरेक्टली बाय लोअरिंग अ जियोफोन टू ईच फॉर्मेशन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, sending out a source of energy from the surface of the earth and recording the resultant signal in the wellbore. Check shore survey can also be defined as a type of borehole seismic data designed to measure the seismic travel time from the surface to unknown depth. We can see in the figure on the right hand side, it is the standard check shore configuration. Seismic source is on the surface while geophones have been placed in the wellbore. Seismic signal, I mean only direct arrivals are recorded at receiver points. So it means we consider only first arrival in check shore survey. We can see this is our source. Receivers have been placed here in the wellbore and direct arrivals are being recorded at the wellbore, in the wellbore. Again, the depth of geophone is known here. After recording arrival time of first peak, the seismic velocities can be measured. The data can then be correlated to surface seismic data by correcting the sonic log and generating a synthetic seismogram to confirm or modify our seismic interpretation. These are few more points that describe check shore survey. The first one, it differs from vertical seismic profile in the number and density of receiver depths recorded. Geophone positions may be widely and irregularly located in the wellbore. It is just one difference between VSP and check shore. More differences will come in upcoming slides. It simply means in check shore survey, the geophones are at larger spacing without following a regular pattern and are placed at geological formations contact. Second point is, for a straight or slightly deviated well, the source is positioned near the wellbore and data is collected at coarser geophone increment of maybe around 500 feet or 100 meter. The third point, if the well is deviated and it is deviated more than 10 degree, it is recommended to move the source over the geophone to remain normal incident. The third point, in check shot, data is collected at a coarse geophone increment of 500 feet or 100 meter. Check shot source receiver geometries for various drilling and geological setting. If I start from left to right, the first figure on left hand side is a source receiver geometry commonly used in onshore check shore surveys. This is also called standard configuration. How the check shore data is acquired? The borehole receiver is first lowered to the deepest point here, and the travel time to this deepest receiver position is measured for one or more surface shots. The receiver is then moved in upward direction at a distance of 200, 500 or 1000 feet to record the check shot or vertical travel time at successively shallower levels. The figure 2 that is in the center, we can see this is a deviated well. This source sieve geometry is commonly used to record check shot in a deviated well. The time depth calibration function and velocity analysis that can be calculated from check shore measurements are made reliable if each source receiver travel path is vertical straight line rather than an oblique. Consequently, if a well is deviated, just like here in this case, then the surface position of the source should be readjusted each time the downhole receiver is moved to a new depth level, as shown in the figure, so that the travel path always remains as vertical as possible. This is the deviated well. As receiver is moving away from the well head, we also move short point in such a way that the travel path between source and receiver should be vertical. And the third figure here, the source position A or B should be chosen so that the travel path to each receiver is as nearly as vertical the travel path to each receiver is as nearly vertical as possible. When a check shot survey well penetrates into the formations that exhibit complicated structural dips, it is advisable to position an energy source on the both up dip and down dip sides of the well, so that the two different travel time measurements are acquired at each receiver depth. Now I will discuss various applications of check shot survey. The first one is, it is used to find the seismic attenuation or Q, I mean quality factor of rocks. The second point, it is used for acoustic log calibration and accurate synthetic seismogram generation. I would like to talk a bit more about this point. Sonic data corrected by check shot is done because there is a difference in orientation of the ray path. Like the traces of seismic rays in the check shot survey are relatively perpendicular to the rock layer, while the sonic traces tend to be parallel. This difference result in a difference in the travel time, which we know as a drift curve. The examples in next slides will show how it is used for acoustic log calibration and for correlation with surface seismic data. The next application, the third point is, it is used for improved velocity analysis for surface seismic data processing, like average interval and RMS velocity data. The velocities are used in many data processing steps like NMO, migration, and staking, which are obtained from RMS velocities peaked during velocity analysis of surface seismic data. And we know in surface seismic velocities, velocities survey, the velocities are picked by indirect methods and therefore have more chance of uncertainty. And I already talked how VSP or check shot provide better and more accurate velocities than surface seismic data. It is also used for better tie to surface seismic data because it has more accurate velocities. True seismic velocities, accurate time and depth correlation. More accurate velocities means more better depth conversion. Other application of check shot survey includes, it can be used for accurate time depth correlation, one way or two way or vertical times. It is used for wellbore position verification, like placing the drill bit on the seismic section. The third point is it can be used to calibrate the acoustic log, improve correlation of log drive synthetics to the surface seismic data. I think some repetition here. The last point here, it helps to find transmission loss or Q estimation for surface seismic processing enhancement. Actually, transmission loss, maybe due to friction or due to scattering or due to fluid motion, is very important for seismic data resolution. And therefore, modern studies are considering it very seriously in numerical wave modeling. The main outcome of check shot survey is TD curve, or travel time to depth relationship curve, which is very useful for time to depth conversion of seismic data. In check shot, we place geophone at formations of our interest with known depth, and therefore after recording time, velocities can be found. Moreover, it also corrects sonic corrected check shot for the purpose of making synthetic seismogram and velocity scaling, etc. Here in this slide, we can see, if I start from left to right, and the figure on the left hand side is typical check shot survey configuration in which direct waves are being recorded in the wellbore. And the first break, and then in the next figure, the first break our first arrival is being picked here. In the other figure here, if I start from the left, the first figure is the travel time and depth curves overlaid with first break check shot. The second is the sonic corrected check shot in the center. And then this is a synthetic, this one here, sorry. This is a synthetic seismogram, and it has been correlated here with the surface seismic data near the wellbore. It is also called a seismic reference survey. Now here it is a comparison between both methods, check shot and VSP method. So first, a VSP is much more, the first point is a VSP is much more detailed survey than a check shot survey, because the geophones are more closely spaced, typically on the order of 25 meter or 82 feet. Whereas in check shot, survey might include measurements of intervals hundreds of meter apart. So the first difference is the density of geophone. Geophone are apart in have been placed at a more coarser interval in the check shot survey. In the second point, the VSP uses the reflected energy contained in the recorded traces at each receiver position, as well as the first direct path from source to receiver. While in check shot survey, we only record direct path travel time. So it means in check shot, we only record direct arrivals, while in VSP, we record both check shot, both reflected and direct arrivals. The last point, in addition to tying well data to seismic data, the vertical seismic profile also enables converting seismic data to zero phase data and distinguish primary reflections from multiples. While in check shot survey, we only record direct arrivals and only first break is picked. So it was all about the comparison between these two methods. And of course, we already see in VSP methods, there are a lot of applications and types of VSP methods as compared to check shot survey. This is the end of this video, and thanks for watching. In the next video, I will talk about other well seismic methods, like well shot methods, cross well seismic or well to well seismic methods. If you want to see more helpful videos in future, please subscribe the channel. That way you will get update and notifications anytime new content comes out. If this video helped you, please give it a thumbs up. I hope to see you again with more helpful videos in future. Take care. Bye-bye.